Hello, hello. Welcome to Reading Time. My name's Time, and this week we're reading the Goosebumps series by R.L. Stine. Let's get to reading. Goosebumps is a children's horror series, and each book kind of follows its own plot line. Each book has its own horror elements and protagonists. There are a few books that have reoccurring characters, but for the most part, they are standalone books. Now, Goosebumps is a very large series. The original series by itself is 62 books, and there are multiple breakoff series as well. So for this challenge, I only read 5 books because I found a 5-pack. I read The Cuckoo Clock of Doom, The Haunted School, Piano Lessons Can Be Murder, Stay Out of the Basement, and The Werewolf of Fever Swamp. Now, as I said, the majority of the books can stand alone. They have different protagonists, different villains, but there are some similarities between the different books. For one, each story typically is told from the perspective of a preteen, usually about 12 years old. Each book typically has a supernatural element that is behind the horror aspect. And the majority of the books have a lot of chapters that end in cliffhangers. Overall, I'm going to give this book series a 4-star rating. It definitely is an enjoyable series, and it's one of my favorites that I read when I was really little. In fact, this series was one of the first chapter book series that I read, but it's definitely not the most high quality series. There's a lot of a formulaic feel once you read more than one book, which makes sense because R.L. Stine really just wrote a lot of these. So there's just this feeling of mass production to the series at some points, but it's still enjoyable, and especially since there's not a whole wide range of horror options for children's literature, it's a solid series. As far as content goes, it's hard to give specifics with a series so large, but generally you can expect some level of violence in a lot of the stories. The protagonists are usually at risk of dying or getting hurt in some way, and sometimes they are hurt. Additionally, these books are often scary, but that does depend on the reader. Some people are going to be more scared of some things than others. So being aware of what you as a reader or what your young reader might be afraid of is important to keep in mind before reading these books. These books would be a great way to teach writing cliffhangers or creating suspense in your writing, especially for early readers. A lot of these cliffhangers end up being something non-scary. They have an explanation that isn't the monster or another scary element, but they still create suspense and lead up to the climax of the story where there is some confrontation with the monster of the book. Now, not all of the books necessarily have a specific monster per se. Sometimes it's a cursed object. For example, my favorite one out of the series when I was younger, and one of the ones I read this time around as well, The Cuckoo Clock of Doom, deals with a cuckoo clock that sends everyone back in time. So the protagonist has to figure out how to fix the clock before he ceases to exist. So in that case, there's not a specific monster or ghost or villain per se. Instead, the antagonist is this clock. So overall, it's a fun series, even if it doesn't have a whole lot of exceptional literary merits. Still is a solid one for the children's horror genre. And since there are so many different types of stories and characters, there's bound to be one that your young reader will enjoy. For the poster square for this week, we are right near the bottom with this mummy. Let me know what you think of the Goosebumps series. If you have read it, is there a specific book that you enjoyed? And let me know if you have any other book recommendations. If you are not already, feel free to subscribe to the channel and follow me on Facebook or Instagram for updates about what I'm reading. Now, as always, have a marvelous week and a wonderful read. Thank you.